When House Representative Ted Yoho gravely insulted Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, she initially was going to just let it go, but perhaps anticipating fallout, when he engaged in a floor of the House apology, non-apology, she decided it was time to go to war, not just on her own behalf, but on that of all women. Alexandria won her Congress seat just as Jupiter was entering the sign of her ascendant, Sagittarius, back in November of 2018. Presumably, when Saturn entered Capricorn at the beginning of 2018, she got to work on what then might have seemed like an improbable dream. But then she won handily in November and has been a high-profile member of the Democratic Party ever since. This illustrates the helpful energy of a challenging Saturn toward actualizing ambitions. If one gets to work on the task, should a helpful Jupiter cycle show up at the right time, chances are really good for success. Nevertheless, even with that Jupiter ascendant connection helping her profile all through 2019, she was also faced with a lot of controversy on account of her strong progressive views, sometimes not quite in sync with the broader party's positions. And she also faced the vulgar tirades of a racist, xenophobic president as he tried to make her into the face of the Democratic Party by strongly insinuating her views were fully representative of all Democrats. This is where Saturn in square transit is almost always going to at least give you a hard time, even if it doesn't mean the demise of your cause. In her progressions, the progressed moon was just about to enter Taurus when she entered Congress, which put it on the opposite side of her progressed sun in Scorpio. This is further confirmation of a pinnacle in her life and career. The progressed full moon cycle is an indicator of something important coming to fruition. What is interesting about her clash with Yoho, who I should say, based on the way he's transacted this fiasco, might perhaps consider changing his name to Yahoo, which would be a much better reflection of his character and skill. You can see transiting Mars exactly opposite her Mars. This is classic textbook astrology, putting the, well, martial energy of Mars, what else, on full display. Nothing like a Mars opposition to get you into a fight. Of course, Alexandria does have Eris opposite Mars Sun, which puts her in the social warrior class. Eris is a female warrior intent upon redressing the injustices perpetrated by men on women. This is bad news for Yahoo, since Eris as a planet is not just ascendant in the world sense during this period in history, which puts him on the wrong side of the issue, but also triggers the wrath of a congresswoman that, aside from the belief she may hold, also happens to be very intelligent and articulate. Yoho is really something. In his crocodile tears apology, non-apology, he seemed to be crying mostly for himself and his heroic rise from the ashes of poverty to the glory of a Congress seat. And he topped it off by mentioning that for a time he had subsisted on food stamps. Interesting in that apparently once he got his ass comfortably seated in the House of Representatives, he voted against food stamps. Nice. Perfectly in line with the way the Republican Party operates these days. Not just full-on corruption, but total hypocrisy as well. No birth time for him, but you can see transiting Pluto is squaring his sun, and Saturn isn't really finished with that sun until late in the year. So I think he probably bought himself some grief with all of this. And of course, transiting Mars would be going through his Aries sun sign, and not too far from that Mercury to connect him to lots of ego and to a hothead explosion complete with expletives. For Ocasio-Cortez, the switch to Aquarius by Jupiter and Saturn will mean an easier flow of energy over the next several years because those planets will support her Libra energy by trine. And while this might mean she'll start to relax and take it a little easier, it's quite doubtful she'll let up on her outspoken warrior energy because I notice her progressed ascendant at nearly 14 degrees Capricorn is soon to square her natal Mars at 1541 Libra, followed by the square to her natal Eris at 1645. And this means 2 to 3 years of this kind of action. So perhaps the two big dogs in Aquarius will simply facilitate the expression of her activist progressive views.